praise the Lord, beloved. He has been empowering us with wisdom for his kingdom, for kingdom agenda, for kingdom assignment, for kingdom work. And I believe in God that this devotional has caused you this week to become a minister again, to recapture your zeal for winning souls, to recapture your zeal for touching lives for God. You see, beloved, when you stopped ministering, you became selfish, and you grew in your selfishness until people asking you for help now irritates you. Then God sent me to deliver you and to help you reorientate so you can come back into the ministry, into the army of the Lord, into his assignment as he has ordained it. Glory to God. That's what we're believing God for. And we will spend more time, even next week, to make sure that we connect. Once again, we want to pick up here in John chapter 5. Jesus answered and said, "My Father worketh hitherto, and I work." Therefore, the Jews sought more to kill him because he had not only broken the Sabbath, beloved, but also said also that God was his Father, making himself equal with God. I didn't even think of this when I talked about this on Wednesday and Thursday. Think of it. The Bible says, "Thou shalt do no murder." But the people don't think of that. No, but if you violate the Sabbath, we're going to kill you. You're going to break one law to fulfill another. Religion is a terrible thing. That's the same thing that happened to us believers in the New Testament. That's why I did the lesson on the spirit of right. Because you could be right and end up dead right. You could be right and end up in sin because you are defending something, and then you get out of love and you get into hatred and bitterness. Is the same thing we are dealing with today. Then answered Jesus and said unto them, "Verily, verily, or truly, truly, I say unto you, the Son can do nothing of himself." Yes, I didn't quite hit this, and I want to get into it today. He said, the Son can do nothing of himself. If Jesus can say that, then what are we out there doing on our own? Jesus could have done things on his own, but he said, no, I cannot do the will of God on my own. I have to receive it. I remember years ago, I just got so tired of all the troubles in ministry, and I wanted to further, and I wanted to minister more and all of that. And I started engaging my friends that had churches and ministering for them. And one day I was in this church, and they were getting ready to announce me, and all of a sudden I felt so empty. It scared me. And I said, "Lord, what in the world is going on?" He said, "Who sent you out here?" So, say, "Who sent you out here?" I said, "Okay, Lord, I'm sorry. If you just let me do this meeting, and I'll go back and sit home, and I will not go anywhere again." I did the meeting, it was all right. And I went home, and I never attempted to go anywhere again until God spoke to me to start Resurrection House for all nations. Hallelujah, this global movement. Beloved, that's what the Holy Spirit is dealing with you. I left the broadcast yesterday talking about people that are excellent controllers. You are great planners. You strategize. And people even teach you to do that. But the life of the Spirit doesn't work that way. Sometimes I've prayed and prepared a message, and God will get into the service and start doing something else. And man that is led of the Spirit, Jesus says, like wind. Don't know where it's coming from, don't know where it's going. So it's everyone led of the Spirit, beloved. It's not mastered out and crafted and all these things people are saying. Say, the Son can do nothing of himself. We are not self-actuated. No. We are responders to God. What we do is we seek God. We pray until we come into his presence where we can hear him, receive unctions from him, impressions. However you get it, but get something. Receive grace from the Lord. Because the blessing of it is that when he touches you with that unction or that impression, the grace to carry it out is present. You just get it done. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. Sometimes I've been in meetings or even in a leadership meeting, and I just have an impression. I had one recently to touch my secretary's hand. And the moment I touched her, she said the fire of God just exploded in her spirit, and she fell off. You have impressions, and the grace is bad. I remember I looked at one of my spiritual daughters were in a meeting, a leadership meeting. I said, come here. God just spoke to me. You are the daughter of my right hand. And I took her hand. Her right hand to right hand. She said she felt like a kick in her gut. She fell out like boom, and strength came in. And resurrection since then is flowing in her life mightily. Hey, there's grace released when we get that impression, we get that unction in the name of Jesus. See, beloved, we have to continue with this next week. But he says, verily, verily, I say unto you, the Son can do nothing of himself, but what he seeth the Father do. Yes, he reveals his work to us, and then we act it out. That is why the beginning of this maturity, this growth, this ministerial involvement with God is first pushing into a relationship with God, pushing into the word and in prayer until you can start hearing and knowing and seeing and receiving what the Father is saying. What a way to end this week. It's been wonderful. I'm so excited. We will get into it more next week, and I believe greater things shall happen. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you. Bye-bye.
The Lord is waiting on you. Yes, he is, yes, he is, yes, he is, yes, he is.